the water level at Lake Mead has risen above where it was this time last year. That is according to the Bureau of Reclamation. This is all due in part to that water release we told you about.
Lake Mead, the majestic jewel straddling Arizona and Nevada, has been making headlines like never before. This year alone, it's undergone some truly startling shifts. From alarming water lows to sudden surges, the changes have been impossible to ignore. But that's not all. Rumors swirl of peculiar findings deep below its waves. Discoveries that have left seasoned experts bewildered, and some tales that, let's just say, might just send shivers down your spine. So what tales are hidden beneath Lake Mead's undulating surface? Could these mysterious events pose a threat to the delicate balance of nature? Come with us on this enthralling expedition. Hold tight and dive into the heart of the mystery. And oh, before we delve in, make sure to hit that subscribe button to join us on more exciting adventures. Now picture this. East of Las Vegas, Lake Mead is a vast aquatic sentinel, ensuring a steady water supply for the arid southwest US. Cities like Las Vegas, Henderson, North Las Vegas, and Boulder City lean heavily on this reservoir, with a staggering 25 million people depending on its bounty. To put its enormity into perspective, at its brimming best, Lake Mead sprawls over 640 square miles with an awe-inspiring capacity of 28,945,000 acre-feet, making it the undisputed champion of reservoirs in the US. But it hasn't always been smooth sailing. Over recent years, the lake's surroundings have battled severe droughts. In a shocking revelation, water levels once plummeted to a worrying 177 feet, a sight not witnessed since the start of this millennium. This decline unveiled stretches of the barren lake bed, leaving eerie reminders of what once was. But then, as if nature decided to throw a curveball, water levels started climbing, confounding experts and raising questions. What mysterious force is at play here? And can it breathe life back into the lake, restoring its former majestic aura? Let's rewind a bit and dive into Lake Mead's fascinating backstory. The lake isn't just a natural wonder and a testament to human ingenuity. Snow melts from the towering Rocky Mountains cascade down the Colorado River, feeding into the lake. But that's not all. Acting as Lake Mead's guardian is the iconic Hoover Dam. When built in 1936, this huge structure was a sign of hope, with the promise that it would stop floods and turn deserted lands into fertile ones. Today, it irrigates over 2 million acres annually and is a timeless testament to human resilience and innovation. Join us as we embark on this enthralling expedition into Lake Mead's depths, uncovering stories, unraveling mysteries, and perhaps encountering the unknown. The Hoover Dam stands as a remarkable testament to human ingenuity. Rising to a height of 726.4 feet and stretching 1,244 feet, it comprises 3.25 million cubic yards of concrete and an intricate 4.4 million cubic yards of embankment construction. But the Colorado River, which used to bring a lot of water to the dam, has been losing a lot of water primarily because of the harmful effects of climate change. This has resulted in a severe drought, with the river losing 83% of its water, turning once fertile lands barren. Lake Mead's primary lifeline is Lake Powell, nestled between Utah and Arizona. This reservoir was birthed from the overflow of the Glen Canyon Dam. More than just a water supplier to Lake Mead, Lake Powell serves many purposes. It is a pivotal water source for the lower basin states like California, Arizona, and Nevada. It boasts the title of being the second largest reservoir after Lake Mead. Holding an impressive 26 million acre-feet of water, it has been an unfaltering safety net for countless years, drawing tourists from across the globe looking for leisure and recreation. What makes Lake Powell particularly intriguing to researchers is its significant role in hydroelectric power generation. The Glen Canyon Dam, the heart of Lake Powell, is crucial for Lake Mead's survival. It channels most of the water supply and powers a considerable portion of the southwest United States and even parts of Mexico. While a chunk of this water is directed to urban areas in the southwest, the lion's share goes towards irrigation. But here's a question that has puzzled scientists. How would Lake Mead fare without the Glen Canyon Dam? Delving into Lake Mead's history, it's evident that its water levels have been on a roller coaster ride. It brimmed with water during its prime in the 1980s and 90s, even causing the infamous 1983 flood. But fast forward a few decades, and it's been a story of decline. A decline so severe that by 2016, it rested at just 1,040 feet above sea level. Flash to 2022, and the lake hit an all-time low, starkly contrasting its glorious heights during its inception in the 1930s. But every cloud has a silver lining. In February 2023, Lake Mead showed signs of resurgence, hitting 1,047.38 feet, utilizing 30% of its maximum capacity. This upturn in fortunes has shifted perceptions from a grim forecast to a brighter outlook for Lake Mead. Realizing how serious the situation was, steps were taken in 2020 to fight back against the effects of climate change and rising water use. The government's masterstroke was the construction of low-level pumps, which remarkably enhanced the health of Lake Mead's ecosystem. Designed to ensure water access for southern Nevada even under dire circumstances, these pumps acknowledge the lake's fragile state and a commitment to averting future disasters. Top of form. Even after installing pumps, the water situation 2022 worsened considerably, forcing greater dependence on these mechanisms. The water reached such critical lows that numerous recreational activities had to be halted. Activities like swimming, fishing, and boating became impossible, deeply affecting residents' lifestyles. Once bustling with diverse vessels, the lake now only permits a limited number due to safety concerns and the lake's diminished capacity to handle the pressure. At a level of 1,047.38 feet, the lake is nearing what is known as the Deadpool state, a critical point at which water cannot flow into dams. Hydropower generation ceases, and recovery becomes next to impossible. The question that looms large is, how long before Lake Mead reaches this irreversible state? In the face of the water crisis, the governments of Arizona, California, and Nevada united for a restoration project. The Bureau of Reclamation took the lead, proposing a $200 million initiative to construct a reservoir akin to a swimming pool to bolster Lake Mead's water levels. This initiative incorporated cutting-edge water conservation techniques and structured water releases, minimizing the strain on the lake. The plan's goal included saving about 326,000 gallons of water from the lake each year, effectively curbing the possibility of complete water depletion and soil dryness. During the winter of 2023, nature played a part in alleviating the crisis. In just 5 days, from April 25th to 30th, the lake's water level increased by 2.5 feet, reaching 1,049.73 feet. This boost is credited to the melting of significant winter snow accumulations in the Colorado Rockies. However, with the ever-changing climate, this relief might be short-lived. A bulk of the essential snowfalls took place in California, especially during the consistent storms from December 27th to January 17th. By April, the rising temperatures induced snowmelt, bringing some relief to drought-impacted areas, especially the Great and Colorado River basins. It's imperative to highlight that adjustments in the release volume from the Glen Canyon Dam occur monthly. This action dictates the water flow to Lake Powell and the reservoir levels of both Lake Powell and Lake Mead. While the recent snowmelt has provided Lake Mead a brief respite from climate challenges, its long-term outlook remains unpredictable. Considering the water increase rate, one might wonder if Lake Mead could overflow again, reminiscent of the 1983 flood. But, given the current circumstances intensified by climate change and prolonged droughts, the likelihood of such an event seems remote. While hope remains, the reality of Lake Mead's situation demands urgent attention and action. According to recent findings, the lake is still a significant 160 feet below its maximum capacity, and Lake Powell trails by 120 feet, even with the snowpack almost completely melted. However, even this minor progress signifies a victory. In 2023, while there are signs of recovery, this progress is but a small fraction of what's needed. The lake would require decades, if not longer, to regain its original state, assuming that's even possible. Presently, the entire region grapples with drought, albeit less severe than before. Experts in 2023 suggest that with the year's trend towards increasing warmth, Lake Mead's levels won't be much rise. Yet the 2023 El Niño cycle could change things, potentially ushering in a colder, wetter winter. Historically, this phenomenon increases rainfall in the northern US, California, and Washington. However, due to the erratic nature of climate change, this El Niño might not behave traditionally. El Niño, known for altering global atmospheric patterns and impacting ocean temperatures and currents, is becoming increasingly unpredictable. Though historical data can guide predictions, a cautious and prepared approach is essential, given nature's increasing unpredictability. On the preservation front, the government's proposal to reduce the water supply for all six beneficiary cities of Lake Mead has been discussed for 6 months, hindered by state disagreements. Many neighboring river basin states have agreed to the water regulation plan, but California, a major water consumer, has resisted. In August 2022, federal directives aimed at reducing water withdrawals from Lake Mead and the Colorado River were proposed, taking effect in January 2023 due to the declared water emergency. To keep Lakes Powell and Mead from drying up, water is channeled into Colorado's water systems to replenish their reserves. The Colorado River system, essential to over 40 million people across seven states, is at risk, having experienced severe water loss from prolonged drought and overexploitation. Surprisingly, Lake Powell has seen over a 5-foot rise in water levels, contradicting the U.S. Bureau of Reclamation's predictions. However, their reports warn of potential electricity outages, as decreased water levels could halt the dam's turbines. In a bold move, Arizona imposed a 3-year hiatus on using Lake Mead's waters in 2023, encouraging conservation and easing the burden on the lake. Both California and Nevada followed suit. Despite these sacrifices, a challenging journey lies ahead. However, by 2026, an estimated 3 million acre-feet of water could be conserved. Addressing water misuse, Arizona revoked permits for two wells on Saudi Arabia's alfalfa farm, which had been excessively drawing groundwater. Attorney General Chris Mays emphasizes the need for immediate action to confront the intensifying water crisis. Such drastic measures have garnered mixed reactions. Many residents, accustomed to abundant water supplies or reliant on the lake for their livelihoods, view these actions with skepticism and displeasure. Yet, hopes are pinned on 2026. Considering the future, what do you foresee for Lake Mead by 2026? Will the eventual benefits justify the temporary hardships, or are we witnessing the gradual demise of the Colorado River and its tributaries? Concluding, while the efforts to salvage Lake Mead are not flawless, inaction and continued water overuse would surely spell doom, making recovery an impossible dream. What are your perspectives on Lake Mead's future by 2026? Share your insights below, and remember to like, share, subscribe, and turn on notifications for more updates.